we actually have a customer that's partnered with us on this cluster idea. They're as on board as we are, but they're the customer. So, but they're willing to give us all of their feedback and their perspectives as well. Like, are we really hitting the mark? So we're excited to partner with them. We actually are taking the cluster that I designed in the practicum and moving that into reality, actually building it out using some of the customers' learning assets that they have, a lot of their videos and things that they have built for their own people, as well as the things we're going to fill the gaps and build out a larger tool set than just e-learning and classroom education. We're going to really look at forums and all the other things that can prop that up and put that into practice. And our goal is to have it implemented by January with this customer, which is really aggressive. I'm not sure we'll actually hit our goal.
I would really highly recommend choosing something, not just not a practice thing. Do something you plan on implementing, because you'll get a head start on it. The project that I chose was something that had a large value of something that we've dealt with for a long time. And it's in the millions of dollars impact it could have. And I really believe by having this process in place, it will move us, and it'll make an improvement not only on financials, but I think employee retention, because we've got a solution for them. We help get them onboarded quicker. I looked at this one and I said, well, this is a no-brainer. I went to our controller and I just got some numbers from him. And I said, this is worthy of taking to the C-suite and sitting down and saying, here's an opportunity for us, and here's how we can do it.
My learning cluster was a little bit different. I did a learning cluster on learning clusters, so it was very meta. Kind of trying to think about it from the perspective of changing the learning culture at our organization to be one where people do seek out learning assets that fit their needs more actively, rather than just doing the training that's assigned to them or required for them to do. And so we're thinking that what we'll do is roll out some of the assets and ideas that I created during the workshop in the new year, and trying to kind of work with particularly our SMEs and other department managers to kind of champion this new approach to learning that we're hoping people will take on at the company overall. My manager's learning cluster is about implementing our new LMS. So we're getting a new LMS. And so that's very applicable to us right now. We're actually currently creating some of the assets that she came up with in her learning cluster project for the workshop.
I think we're going to see an increase in like the learning objectives, like as far as getting those across the finish line and actually seeing the on-the-job behavior change, which I'm really, really excited about. I'm excited to introduce this model to, you know, leaders of the organization when they do come to our area and say, hey, we had this problem, because I feel like by doing this as opposed to the old way, it's going to make the world of difference. I think the biggest one for me, and I shared this with the group too, was that learning does not have to be, or like the assets that we put together, they don't have to be like these huge, expensive, you know, super tech incorporated things to be effective. It might just be a job aid, because that is what is best for that specific learner group. And I keep telling my boss, who is I work most closely with her, but we keep like having like these moments of like, oh my gosh, it was so amazing. Like, I am so glad that I was able to sign up and attend. I just feel like now I have a better grasp of how to do it now that I've actually done it with that guidance. So I think we're going to make some pretty big progress with that in the future.
So we actually implemented the learning cluster that I designed in the course, which was everyday business storytelling. And it was really great because through the course, I was able to identify a variety of assets, both formal, immediate, and social. And we were able to meet the learners where they were in their own journey of how to tell stories in PowerPoint. And so we've already put those into practice and seen great results from the team on ways in which they can kind of learn in a way that is meaningful to them in and out of the flow of work.